Alright, I'm going to show you now how to reset both of these tensioners. This is a short tensioner. This is found on pre-2000 J-series engines. This is a long tensioner. This one is found on after 2000. Out of both of these tensioners, the best one is the short one. It's more reliable for whatever reason. These tend to leak more often, the longer ones. So I'll call this tensioner L. This we'll call the short one tensioner S. Tensioner L, what happens is around the seal on the inside, you'll start to see oil seeping out from it. Since it's sitting at an angle, it'll start to seep oil kind of from the top here. You can see on this one, it kind of had oil on the top here. It sits at an angle inside the engine, so you'll see one side is dry, one side is wet. Out of these two, tensioner S, the short one, is definitely the better one out of the two. One thing that's kind of cool is you can actually, these are interchangeable. You could actually use the short tensioner on a long tensioner application after 2,000 vehicles. So keep that in mind. Once this tensioner is expanded, there's a little nut right here. It's an 8mm. What you do is you go ahead, you bust this loose, you take this screw out, okay, pull that all the way out, and you have an O-ring right here. Okay, that O-ring has to stay in there for the oil not to leak out. Okay, inside there, if you guys can see that, there's a little screw. You turn that clockwise once the tensioner has been expanded. You guys see that little screw down there? You turn that clockwise once it's been expanded to reset the tensioner. Do not try to put this into a vise, tensioner S. Don't put it into a vise, because if you put it into a vise and start cranking it down, you're just going to destroy it. The only way to reset these is to pull that screw out, turn it clockwise, and reset it. Like I said, I'll show you how to reset both of these. Here's a short tensioner. This clamp right here, you can buy this separately from any Honda dealership. I'll give you the part number right now. Now, out of the two tensioners, this one is the better tensioner. This is found on pre-2000 vehicles, mostly. But like I said before, if you want, you guys can change over a long tensioner to a short one. They are interchangeable, so just keep that in mind. Here's tensioner S. You remove this screw to reset the tensioner. One thing to note is you need this bracket to hold the tensioner in place while you reinstall it on the engine. You can actually buy these from any Honda dealership. I think it's less than 20 bucks. So if you plan on reusing tensioner S, you don't have to buy a new assembly, because when you buy a new tensioner S, it comes with this bracket, this keeper. They actually call it a stopper, is an official name from Honda. You don't have to buy this stopper. You don't have to buy the whole tensioner just to get the stopper. You can buy the stopper independently of the tensioner. Have the stopper ready when you do this job. It'll make it a lot easier. What I'm going to do is I'm have this Craftsman vice grip. And buy this at any Sears. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it and I'm going to hold it, the tensioner, in place here right on the side. Okay, I'm going to lock that down. If I had a vise, I'd be doing it in a vise, but I don't have one. I guess maybe I shouldn't invest in one. Okay, first thing you want to do is pop this bolt loose. It's an 8mm screw. So pull that out. Be careful right here on top. Right there on top is an O-ring. Do not lose that. You need to put that back in place because there is oil inside this tensioner. You have to make sure the oil does not seep out. Okay? Now I have a handy dandy screwdriver here, the one that you guys use, most mechanics use in their pockets, on their shirts. You use these all the time. So now what you're going to do, there's a little screw in here. So on one hand, my left hand here, I'm going to take the stopper. And on the other hand, I'm going to stick this into the hole here. Turn it clockwise. Okay, and while I'm doing that, I'm going to put this here on the bottom. And with my left hand, I'm going to push up while I'm turning on top here. Turning clockwise. And as you can see, it's moving the tensioner up on top. And the bracket is about to be in place.
Okay, it's almost there. A little bit more. And there. Just like that. Don't get me wrong, there's a lot of tension on here. It kind of dented my bottom finger here. No, that's how you reset the tensioner here. So now I'll do is put the O-ring back on. Put the 8mm screw back on. And then tighten it down. So, that's how you do that. Not hard. If you had a vise, it'd probably be a little bit easier. Just as long as you can keep it in place. Make sure that's snug. You don't have to be Superman when you do this. Snug it down. Loosen it up. There you go. Your tensioner S is set and ready to be put back on the vehicle. If it looks damaged in any way or worn or just want some more confidence in it, go ahead and replace it. But this is how you reset it if you plan on reusing it. All right, guys. Here is tensioner 2, the long tensioner. Here's one I took off a previous job. I don't know if you can see this. Hopefully, maybe you can. Let me grab a flashlight. Right down here, you can see it a little bit. There's oil down there. All right? Can you see that? Can you see that? And that's what happens to these things. It leaks out on the top of the tensioner, and it renders these tensioners useless. And if you go ahead and stick this back on, you know, that's leaking oil, you have, you know, there's a high probability that this tensioner will give out, and then, you know, it won't be the timing belt that snaps or anything, or a bearing seizes. It'll be this tensioner that gives out, and you're jumping timing, and those valves are kissing the piston. So if you see any kind of oil on top, go ahead and replace this. It's not worth it. You know, if you're going in this far into the job, might as well do the whole thing right. So this is actually one that I had replaced. This one is already set up. This one came from factory from a component kit I picked up. But as you can tell, the pin's already in here, all right? And I've seen guys say that you can go ahead and use a drill bit to reset it, and that is the case. You can use a drill bit. But what nobody else tells you is that once you put this drill bit in, okay, there's two holes here. Let's see. There's one here, and there's a coinciding one on the top of the tensioner. And you guys can't see that. There you go. Right there. So you basically collapse this like a little piston, like a shock. You line up the two holes, and you stick a drill bit through. So I've seen guys tell me this. What nobody's saying is that once you get the drill bit through and it's sitting on the car ready to be set tension on, you're not pulling this drill bit out by your hand. You got to use a pair of pliers to pull this thing out, because there is so much tension on this drill bit. And the only way you're going to get this thing out is to actually go ahead and just, you know, pull it out with some pliers. So don't expect to be doing this by hand. There's just way too much tension. So I'm going to show you how to reset this thing. It's basically a tiny little piston that's inside of here. And with anything, there's oil that needs to be flown around, that flows around inside of it. So when you do this, you know, tighten a little bit, give it a rest, tighten it up a little bit more. Make sure you have your drill bit of the appropriate size ready to be dropped in that hole. What I'm going to do is lay down on the bench or table, take my C-clamp. I have a piece of wood. The only reason being is that when I usually do this, and it's on a C-clamp. You can also use a vise, but when I do it with a C-clamp, this part right here wants to turn. And it turns when I'm turning it, and this, the top of the tensioner is hitting the top of the C-clamp. It tends to turn this whole assembly in here, so when the holes should be lined up, they're not. So I go ahead and I put a piece of wood here as a spacer to stop the tensioner from turning, if that makes sense. So go ahead, start collapsing the C-clamp. And like I said, you're going to, you know, turn a little bit, wait. Turn a little bit more, then wait. It's basically a little hydraulic piston there. Oil has to flow around to get it to compress. So don't rush it. It's a little bit at a time. You can actually feel it when it's
when I'm doing this, I can feel the tensioner get a little bit harder to turn. Tell me that the fluid isn't moving as quickly, and then you can, you know, give it a second, and then it's ready to be turned a little bit more. So I am almost there, and there it is. It's lined up. Okay, it's lined up. And that's all you need to do to reset tensioner 2. Like I said, if you have, you know, if you're going to replace the whole thing, you're going to get a new pin. And then, obviously, this sits on the engine. You just pull the pin out, and you're good to go. Your tension's set. On this one, if you use a drill bit, you know, of the correct size, when this is actually sitting on the engine, you're not going to be able to grab this with your fingers. You have to use, you know, pliers to pull this thing out. Tensioner 2 is ready to be loosened up. Go ahead, loosen it up. Lock out. Take the C-clamp off. And there it is. If you have this type of tensioner, it's leaking at the top, go ahead and replace it. You don't want to go this far into the job and have it fail on you. You know, 100 miles, 10,000 miles down the road. Do all the critical components at once. You won't have to worry for another 100,000. Yeah, that's how you reset both tensioners.